Purposeful Parenting series. Amanda Olson has allowed us to come on into her space. Amanda, thank you so much for having daytime here.
Glad to have you here.
Yeah, of course. So we are talking about back to school. Right now, a lot of kids are either back in school or they're preparing to go back to school. And this is a really exciting time for not only the kids, but the parents as well, right?
Yes, we feel it here at the studio, you know, kind of building up to this time, the anticipation, the getting ready. It's a fun time.
It is a really fun time. And the thing is too, it just as much as the kids are looking forward to, the parents are too, but it can be a little stressful for the parents, right?
Right, right. A little bit for everybody. Change is always a little stressful.
Right.
So I have some tips today for families going back to school, and even if you've already started, some things that can help make it smooth.
Wonderful. So, well, let's get ahead and get started. So your first tip for parents out there, what is number one?
Well, number one is to plan ahead. You know, anticipate things that might go wrong. Uh-huh. Just have things ready ahead of time, clothes laid out, and you know, all your supplies ready to go. The good thing is the kids can participate in that, and uh-huh. it starts teaching them responsibility and how to do it, start doing it for themselves. So that's the biggest thing, is just kind of plan ahead.
Right. And then, of course, you know, sometimes the best laid out plans don't go so well. Right,
right. Or you didn't even have time to plan ahead. You know, something came up, so you just couldn't prepare. But you can always have a take two, and you can start over and say, okay, now we're going to plan ahead and let's get going from here. So you can right. always adjust as things go.
Right, and that kind of leads into your second tip of just being flexible, right?
Absolutely. You don't want to anticipate things are going to go exactly like you planned.
Right.
And, you know, there's always something. Car line takes a little bit longer, or, you know, the teacher needs one more school supply, mm-hmm. something like that. So be flexible and be prepared for that, and don't let it throw you off.
Right, right. And, you know, you never know what's going to happen when you have kids, right?
No.
Anything can happen.
Anything can
right?
happen. Yeah, just on the car ride to the bus stop, something
yes,
can happen.
Yes, exactly. Just in a few minutes, something can happen. So your third tip, then, tell me a little bit about that.
So one of the things that you can do to really help the child is be supportive of the teacher.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so if you haven't had a chance to meet them already, which most schools have an activity where you
right.
can come and meet the teacher, but if you didn't make that, do your best effort to reach out to them, let them know who you are, put a face to the name.
Mm-hmm.
If you can't do it in person, you know, send a note
mm-hmm.
and introduce yourself. Let the teacher know what's the best way to contact you. And that way the child knows that you're connected to the teacher, and you know, they still feel that not just being dropped off, but mm-hmm. they've got connections. They know that the teacher knows how to get in touch with mom or dad or
right.
caregiver.
I love that. I think that's so smart, especially yeah. for maybe kids going to school for the first time. You know, that might make them feel a little bit more at ease.
Absolutely. You know, they don't know what to expect, and
mm-hmm.
you know, it's the same for them as it is for us when something new happens,
yeah.
you know. So a little hand holding and a little assurance goes a long way.
Definitely. And speaking of, you know, maybe kids going for the first time, or just really no matter what age or grade your kids are, is help them boost their confidence, right?
Absolutely. You know, talk to them and let them know that you're proud of how they did.
Mm-hmm.
They come home and, you know, what happened? And, oh, that was great. I like that. Oh, you got to sit with so-and-so. That's great. You look great today. I like your new school clothes. All that kind of stuff, just to help them feel ready to go. And then, you know, on the other side, if something didn't go quite right, take a little time and say, oh, okay, well, how can we fix that? How can we
mm-hmm.
make it better? Offer a solution.
Yeah, that's wonderful. Just really opening that line of communication. I think no matter what age your kids are, that's always a good thing to have.
Always a good thing. I'm an
yeah.
advocate of that.
Yeah, I love that. Well, Amanda, thank you so much for having daytime here. We really appreciate it.
Yeah, you bet.
And I know you guys are definitely feeling the first kind of day of school here at the studio. You guys are very busy, right?
We are. It's a great time to start new things. And so lots of kids come in and start their martial arts lessons to help them focus in school.
Yeah,
so.
Wonderful. Well, guess what? You can go ahead and come on in and join in on those lessons. Or if you have any questions for Amanda, you can also ask her at Master Mom as well. Thanks again for having daytime here.
Thank you.